Good morning, student. I hope you all are fit and fine. In the last class, I was explaining about the Kepler's laws of planetary motion and then how this laws of planetary motion related to the inverse square rule, and we have proved F is proportional to 1 by r square. This thing we have proved in the last class. Now, today we will deal with the gravity. What you have already know that what is gravity. Gravity is the phenomena, or you can say phenomenon, of attraction between the earth and any other body. Force of attraction between the earth and any other body is called gravity, or you can say that force of gravitation. So as per universal law of gravitation, you have already derived the formula F is equal to G M1 into M2 upon R square. Now, for the gravity, here we take one object as an earth. This is the earth, and another any object, means kept at a distance r. So this formula will become F is equal to G M E into M2 upon r square. Means force of gravitation between the earth and any other object. Force of attraction between the earth and any other object is called gravity or gravitation. Where Me is the mass of the earth and M2 is the mass of the object, and r is the distance between the earth and the object. So this force of gravitation, once again I am telling, the gravity means the phenomenon of attraction between the earth and any other in the object in the universe. With the help of this, we will come to the concept of free fall. What do you mean by free fall? Free fall means whenever you throw any object, what do you observe? It comes down on the earth. Means any object that is falling towards the earth under the action of gravitational force of earth alone are said to be in free fall. Means when any object thrown from a height drops under the force of gravitation, except that there no other force is acting between them, then you can say that the object is in a condition of free fall. Have you ever seen that whenever you drop two objects of different masses, suppose you take a coin and another feather, what you will observe? If you take a feather and one coin, and when you drop it from a height both simultaneously, what you will observe? In practically, you will observe that coin will fall more faster on the ground than in comparison to the feather. Why? Because here force of gravitation is acting on the both the object, but here another force, that is air resistance is acting on both the object, and since this is lighter in weight, more air resistance is acting on it, so it will takes time to fall on the ground, whereas coin, here air resistance is less, so it will soon fall on the ground. But what you know, that whenever an object is falling under the force of gravity, that is under the free fall condition, the falling object on the ground does not depend upon the mass of that object. Means Robert Boyle has done an experiment. He has taken a tube like structure sealed at both end, and here you attach the vacuum pump, and from here you try to drop a feather and a coin simultaneously. What he observed, when these two objects were dropped in this vacuum condition where there is no air resistance is there, what we see, that both the object, coin and feather, both fall on the ground at the same time irrespective of their masses. It means that whenever an object is in a condition of free fall, means whether the object is heavy or light, it doesn't matter, it will drop on the ground at the same rate, provided if there is no air resistance in the nature. So once again I am saying that the acceleration due to gravity as the acceleration produced in a body in free fall due to gravitational force of the earth on the body, means whether the object is heavy or light, it doesn't matter, both the object, when it is under the condition of free fall, the acceleration due to gravity will be same on the body, that is 9.8 meter per second square. So the acceleration of object falling towards the earth does not depend upon the mass of the falling object, means whether the object is heavy or light, it doesn't matter. Under the free fall condition, the acceleration due to gravity will be 9.8 meter per second square, and whether the object is heavy or light, they will fall under the same gravitational force at the same time. So let us see how this acceleration due to gravity, means g, does not depend upon the mass of the falling object. Or you can say that, what is the relationship between small g and capital G? Now, to establish the relationship between small g and capital G, here I have taken an earth as a spherical body having radius Re, and Me is the mass of the earth. An object of mass M kept at a distance from the center of the earth to the center of this object at a distance R. Now, as per universal law of gravitation, force F acting between the object and the earth is F is equal to G M into ME upon R square, where G is the universal gravitational constant, M is the mass of the object, and ME is the mass of the earth, and the distance between the object and the center of the earth is R. So F is equal to G M into ME upon R square. This is the force of gravitation acting between the object and the earth. Now, according to Newton's second law, you know that force F is equal to M into G. Force F is equal to M into G means force acting on the body, that is equal to M into G. So from equation 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, you can write M into G is equal to G into M into ME upon R square. Now, this M mass of the object is cancelled. So, here what we see, G is equal to capital G into ME upon R square. Now see, here the acceleration due to gravity does not depend upon the mass of the object. Suppose this object lies on the surface of the earth here, then this distance will be what? That will be equal to Re. So G is equal to G into ME upon Re square. This is the relation between capital G and small g. Now on substituting the value, the value of capital G is 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square, and mass of the earth is 6 into 10 to the power 24 kg, 6 into 10 to the power 24 kg, and radius of the earth is 6.4 into 10 to the power 6 meter. Now on substituting the value in the formula, 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 into 6 into 10 to the power 24 upon 6.4 into 10 to the power 6 whole square. When you calculate this, the value will be 9.8 meter per second square. The value of G will be 9.8 meter per second square. So this shows that the acceleration due to gravity, small g, does not depend upon the mass of the falling object. Now let us see the variation in acceleration due to gravity. How the value of G changes when their position is changing. Let us see now. Now see, you know that G is equal to capital G M ME upon RA square. Now you know that our Earth is moving around an elliptical orbit, and the radius of the Earth from pole center to the pole, and this is the radius from center to the equator. Here what you see, the value of radius, yani RP, radius of the pole, is less, is less in comparison to the radius of the equator. So you have seen as per formula that G is inversely proportional to 1 by R square. Means if R, any radius from the center to the pole, is less, then the value of G will be more. Means the value of G will be greater at the pole. Means the value of acceleration due to gravity is maximum at the poles. And since the radius of the equator is greater, so the value of G, small g, at the equator is minimum. The value of small g at the equator will be minimum in comparison to the value of G at the pole. So because G is inversely proportional to the square of distance between them, means distance from the center to the radius of the Earth. So if radius of the pole from the center is less, then the value of G is maximum at the pole. If the radius from the center to the surface of the Earth is greater, then the value of G will be minimum at the equator. So as the acceleration due to gravity at pole will be maximum because radius is minimum, and acceleration due to gravity at the equator is minimum because radius is maximum. Similarly, the value of acceleration due to gravity decreases with height above the Earth. Value of G decreases with the increase of height above the Earth surface. This you have already learned about the equation of motion in the first chapter. Let us see the equation of motion you have learned in the first chapter. There are three equations of motion which you have proved graphically or as well as mathematically. How this equation of motion related to gravity. You have seen the three equation of motion. First is V is equal to U plus AT. Second is S is equal to UT plus half AT square. And third equation is V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. These are the three equations. Now, how these three equations? Here, we are writing A, acceleration. So, if you want to relate this equation with the gravity, then instead of A, what we will use? A will be here, acceleration due to gravity. Means, acceleration due to gravity, that is G. So this equation will become in relation to the gravity, V is equal to U plus GT. Second equation will become F, your distance, we will write here height, H. H is equal to UT plus half GT square. And third equation will become V square equal to U square plus 2GH. Here you can write small h also. 2GH. Means whenever you throw the object from against the gravity, the value of G will be negative. And whenever the object is thrown from a height, the value you will take plus G. So later on we will deal with the numerical also related to this equation. Now you should remember few important points while solving the numerical based on this equation, that when a body is allowed to fall freely from a height, means when an object is allowed to fall freely from a height, then in that case the initial velocity of the body is zero. Means whenever any object is thrown under the force of gravity from a certain height, there you will take U as a zero. Second point, when a body is falling downwards, which I already told you, whenever the object is falling downwards from a height to the towards the ground, then you will take as a plus G, means value of G will be plus 9.8 meter per second square. And whenever body is thrown vertically upwards, means from the ground when it is thrown upward, then value of G is minus, that is we will take G is equal to minus 9.8 meter per second square. जब नीचे से ऊपर की ओर हम फेंकेंगे, then we will take the value of G in a negative difference. और जब ऊपर से हम कोई ऑब्जेक्ट नीचे की ओर फेंक रहे हैं, in that case we will take the positive value of G. At the highest point, when the object reaches to the highest point, the velocity of the body, means final velocity of the body, will becomes zero. And from the highest point, and the body falls with zero, and acceleration due to gravity will be 9.8 meter per second. Means when an object is thrown and when it reaches to the highest point, there the velocity, final velocity, becomes zero. As soon as the final velocity becomes zero, the body will start falling towards the downward. So the time of ascent will be equal to the time of descent. The next point is that distance covered by freely falling body is directly proportional to the square of time of fall. The distance covered by a freely falling body is directly proportional to the square of the time of fall. Next point is that the velocity with which a body strikes the ground is always equal to the velocity with which it was projected upwards. Means the velocity with which body strikes the ground is always equal to the velocity with which it was projected upwards. Means जिस velocity से हम इसको ऊपर की ओर फेंके थे, उसी velocity से ये ground को strikes करेगा. So these are the points which you should remember while solving the problems. Now let us see what is mass and weight. Before going to the topic mass and weight, we will give some differences between capital G and small g. Let us see what is the difference between capital G and small g. Now small g is also called as acceleration ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी. कैपिटल जी इज कॉल्ड ग्रेविटेशनल कॉन्स्टेंट. ग्रेविटेशनल कॉन्स्टेंट. सेकेंड पॉइंट, द वैल्यू ऑफ जी चेंजेस. Here it remains constant everywhere. Means its value is 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. But the value of G is equal to 9.8 meter per second square at the equator. At equator, but at the pole this value will be changed. In another planet the value of G will be changing. So the value of G may be positive, negative or zero also. It depends upon the conditions. Whereas the value of capital G remains constant everywhere. Third is, it is a vector quantity, whereas it is not a vector quantity. Its value will never be zero. Capital G, the value is never zero. So these are the some differences between capital G and small g. Now children, I hope you are able to differentiate the capital G and small g. Now in the next class we will again deal with the next part of this chapter, that is mass and weight. What is mass and what is weight, and what is the difference between mass and weight? And also we will calculating the mass of the object on the earth and mass of the object on the moon, how it is related to that. The mass of the object on the earth is what, and the same object when it is put on the moon, then there what will be the mass of the object. You know that you will see that mass of any body always remain constant. It does not change whether it is on the moon or on the earth, but the weight of the object changes on different planet because the value of small g is changing. So we will see in the next class how the weight of the object changes from one planet to another planet. Till then I hope you are able to understand what I have taught you today. If you have any queries, you can ask during the questionnaire period. Till then children, goodbye. Have a nice day children. We hope we will meet again in the next class. Thank you. Till then remain or stay at home, be safe and always focus your interest towards the study. Thank you. Have a nice day children.